5.
Happy Thanksgiving!
Hey! How are you doing?
How are you doing?
How are you?
This is from your friends at the Towers. Huh? Yeah, just a little goodbye gift. Some surplus goodies from the kitchen, and the chef wanted me to make sure and give you this to remember him by.
Hey,
anybody here ever eaten oysters with seaweed stuffing or bourbon sweet potatoes with slivered almonds? Well, today's your lucky day, Frank.
Well, you know what, ladies? Well, Dad, you know what? Today is your lucky day because we went out and got you something here from AAA. It is a map that has all the highlighted best spots between here and the Pacific Ocean for you and Mom.
Frank, thank you. Thank you, little booby. I didn't know.
See, we want the two of you to have the time of your lives and send us postcards from every place you go.
Yeah.
Why don't we just get this stuff out into the kitchen?
Okay. I'll help.
Yeah.
What is with you guys, huh? I mean, I thought you'd be trying to talk them out of moving.
No.
Not trying to talk them into it.
Listen, this is his idea.
Yeah, it's called a little reverse psychology here, Hannah.
Yes, reverse psychology. See, we are supposed to act as happy as we possibly can in hopes that, well, Nadine and Buzz will not get in their car and drive away so fast tomorrow.
And we were worried about the kids missing us too much, huh?
Jenna, you're a little late for Halloween.
Goody Bradshaw to you, my son. Now, you see, Goody is short for good wife, but I'm nobody's wife, as we know. And, well, I would have been stoned in the wee old days if I were a single parent. I don't smell any turkey basting. I don't smell any mince pie cooling on the windowsill. Are you going to tell me that all my efforts for a festive day were in vain?
Alan Michael is spending the day elsewhere, and I've just been here thinking about the Thanksgivings spent at the Spaulding Mansion, and vowing that next year I would be there, sitting at the head of the table with my son beside me, instead of here surrounded by all these gargoyles. Present company excluded.
Well, you know how I feel about these things. My motto is, you've got to live every minute to its fullest. So I think that you should include present company, and we should make this a festive occasion, even if it is just you and me. So what do you say, Alan? Come on.
Okay, the turkey's in.
Didn't even land on the floor once.
Good, hon.
Oh, Ross. I'm sorry. It's such a shame that you have to wait one whole day to wait for the bank to correct this mistake on that stupid escrow account. I mean, it's really a crime that they make us spend a holiday thinking about criminal charges and disbarment when you didn't even do anything wrong.
I know, honey, and I agree. This subject is off limits, at least for today. Besides, your father is coming, and he's been doing enough gloating lately.
Honey, this is the first Thanksgiving we are going to spend as a married couple. Please, I would like it to go well.
So would I. The outlaw in-laws are here.
Be good.
I will.
Hi! Happy Thanksgiving, darling.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Brought along my own carving set, and I sharpened the knife myself for the occasion.
Good. Which one of us are you going to use it on, Roger?
Hey, is that a squash casserole?
Yes, it is.
Great.
Let me put it in the oven for you.
Great. And I'll get this out of harm's way.
Great.
I'm sorry. Don't pull at me. I'm sorry. Just when I saw him, it reminded me that he was hanging around Ed's arraignment yesterday like a carrion crow. Plus, he's been making Ed sound like this deranged dipsomaniac on this vanity TV station of his. But I promise, I'll do it. If I'm going to spend the day with this man, it's going to take every ounce of my patience.
Hey!
Hi!
Hey!
Oh!
Where's,
Oh, dear. Where's
little Petey?
Huh? He's not here yet. Josh is bringing him over. I just came by to help Bridget and to see you.
Yeah, you look great.
Thanks. What are you doing?
Oh, I'm making the kitchen a little more user-friendly for Dylan. You see these knobs I got?
Yeah.
Different shapes for different drawers, so he'll know what's what.
Oh, that's a great idea. Yeah, I didn't even know these things existed. Hi, Dylan.
Hi.
Hi, honey. Come here. Matt was just telling me how he's going to make the kitchen a little bit more easy to find everything in. He can probably tell you himself.
Later, okay? You know, I appreciate everything everyone's doing for me. But today, I just like to feel like I'm no different from anybody else, all right?
Sure, Dylan.
Thank you.
This portion of Guiding Light is presented by Pringles. So fresh, once you pop, you can't stop.
Join Dan Rather on 48 Hours tonight.
Accepted an invitation from Eleanor and John, dining at the country club.
Oh, well, why did you do that? We were going to have dinner over at the boarding house this year because of Dylan. You knew that we would include you in whatever plans we made.
Maybe your mother wouldn't feel comfortable surrounded by a table of Lewis's.
Oh, Mindy, nothing's further from the truth. You know I adore your relatives. As I hope our offer of financial aid and assistance at this time will prove. But anyway, I can't cancel this reservation. I'm not at this late date. And perhaps within the holiday spirit, Nick, you can convey to Vanessa our good intentions toward her family.
I'll try.
Now, Mindy, will you kindly give everyone my best holiday wishes? Of course, especially Dylan. My heart goes out to him right now. And if there's anything at all we can do...
Well, the best thing we can do for Dylan is to help them out right now.
Yes, well, I hope that works. I better go get ready, so you two have a lovely day.
Melinda? Hey. Will you please tell me what's bothering you? You didn't sleep last night. You hardly touched your breakfast.
Nick, do you know how much my family means to me? How much I want us all to be one family?
Melinda, I want the same thing.
Well, I thought that you did. But your mother seems to have so much influence over you these days. You're even thinking like her.
Well, I mean, is that so bad? You know, there's not many people out there more savvy than my mother when it comes to business.
Business is not all there is to life. Your mother's alone right now because she loves Spalding more than anything else in the world. More than Fletcher. More than her own brother. Maybe even more than you.
Excuse me, Aunt Mistress. The cook wants to know how many frolicking little Puritans you're going to have at your Turkey Day bash and when you want the festival meal served on the table.
Fine, Donna. You tell her she can serve any time, and there will be just one at the table.
Is this some kind of act of charity on your part, Jenna?
No, it most certainly isn't. The thought of sitting in that hotel room watching the parade on TV and picking at some turkey that was sent up by room service does not enchant me.
Can I get you something?
Why, yes. That would be very charitable of you. Speaking of charity, I spoke to Alexandra at the hospital, and her version of why she dropped the lawsuit for me was... Well, a little different. She said that Buzz was my benefactor.
Well, it sounds like my sister is trying to undermine your loyalty to me, huh?
Yes, that crossed my mind. But I don't think Buzz would lie about something like that.
Oh, I think he would consider a harmless little deception if Alexander made it lucrative enough for him.
You know, you always do know what to say, don't you? For me, on the other hand, I have to think of the most logical answer. And that would be that probably you were the one who helped me. Because, unfortunately, I don't think that Buzz was lying about leaving Springfield forever.
Frankly, that might be the best thing for your peace of mind.
I used to beg him to leave with me. So now he's leaving, but he's going with... No, you're absolutely right. Out of sight, out of mind. Well, we're quite a pair, aren't we? Yeah. Me pining over Buzz, you over Tangi.
I don't have time to pine away for anything except Spaulding.
Don't tell me that you relish the idea of living the rest of your life alone. Corporations don't cuddle up very well.
I'm human, Jenna.
Are you?
Sure. I wouldn't mind considering a relationship of companionship if it didn't get in the way of my goals.
It's too bad we're not in love. I mean, we'd make a perfect pair. Oh, why didn't I? It's brilliant. Why didn't I think of this? We've got to do it. And it's absolutely brilliant. We have to do it.
Do what, Jenna?
Get married.
I guess I should start by apologizing for getting upset with you yesterday. It gave me a lot to absorb.
I really should have told you everything sooner.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm trying to understand, Tangi. The two of us, we shared so much at the boathouse while I was there. We confided in each other. You knew how much my father meant to me, how much it meant to me to find him, and you kept it a secret from me.
No, wait a minute. I didn't know that this friend I had was your father until after I shot him.
The guy you told me about, you said he was hitting on you, that he was basically some kind of a stalker.
Well, yeah, well, what was I supposed to say? Hey, guess what? This guy, he's your dad. Once I knew who he was, I realized that I'd misread his behavior.
Why was that?
A stranger comes into your life, right? Mysterious about everything that he is. You have to fill in the blanks about who he is and what he wants. But say that the stranger is Alan Spaulding. And he's returning from prison, incognito, not wanting anybody in town to know who he is. It sheds a whole different light on everything.
So you're saying that nothing went on between the two?
Nothing except a very strange friendship.
Friends don't normally hit on each other, Tangi.
Hello, Michael. People, even your father, gets lonely and confused. And they turn to people. And then they're sorry afterwards.
Yeah, I know. It just depends on if they're sorry because things went further than they wanted them to.
Nothing like that ever happened.
Hey, look, it's okay. It's all right. It's none of my business. The thing that bothers me is that, Tangi, after my father was shot and you knew who he was, why didn't you tell me then?
You can't know how I felt to be standing there, realizing that I shot someone, that it was my friend, and then hear you calling him father?
So, why didn't you tell me then?
I wanted to, very much.
Come on, Tangi, that's not an answer.
I know. What are you doing for Thanksgiving?
Well, I thought about going to my Uncle Ed's, but seeing as how he's been arrested, I don't think I'll be going there.
Would you come with me to Ross and Blake's?
No. No, I don't think that the prospect of sitting across from Ross and having him glare at me the whole meal is too inviting.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. I think I'm just going to take a walk and do some thinking. Okay. Dad, I'm going to be all right, okay? Go. And go enjoy your dinner.
Saute the oysters and the seaweed before I stuff it? Before I put in the stuffing?
Sure, yeah.
Don't make it taste any worse.
What did you say?
I said it's nice that Hans gave you this present.
Isn't it? You know, I liked working for him. That's too bad.
Hey, Hans!
Oh,
hi, how are you? I just wanted to stop by and wish you both bon voyage.
Oh, Nadine, I'd appreciate that. Where's Nadine? Nadine!
I'm here!
Nadine, let me help you with that.
Oh, careful. Oh, that's so nice of you. Don't worry about it.
It's fine. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you. You too. Julie. Thank you for coming by. I thought you were mad at me for leaving.
Oh, no. Well, any station manager would not be happy about losing a show with as many fans as yours has.
Hey, you know, we're going to bring a video camera. We can send you episodes back from the road, you know.
Okay, we'll try that.
Yeah.
Well, in any event, good luck. And take care of yourself.
Thank you. You too.
Hey.
What? What?
Are you watching my pies so they don't burn? That's why you're wearing that hat, huh?
Okay, all right.
Okay. Hey, what's this?
Oh, that's the silverware that I won on Soulmates. I had to sell the rest of the prizes, you know, to raise money for the trip, but I couldn't bear to part with this. This is just so beautiful, isn't it?
It is.
It's a perfect dress-up for the holiday table.
Oh, this is absolutely beautiful, but, Mom, I don't think you're gonna have enough room to take it with you, are you?
Yeah, but then again, how much use do you have for silverware in a motel, right?
Well, we could always send it to you. I mean, that is, if you ever get back into a house.
Well, of course we're going to get back into a house. What do you think, I'm going to spend the rest of my life in a motel room?
Oh, no, honey, I did not mean it that way.
The pies are ready to come out. How long do you roast chestnuts?
15 to 20 minutes.
Yes, and be sure to stick a fork in them or they will explode.
Of course.
Well, I think this is going to be big enough. What do you think?
Buzz is cooking enough for an army in there.
Yeah, we'll be eating leftovers for a month.
No, we don't have to eat leftovers. We'll take one of those big coolers, fill it up with everything, and put it in the car with Nadine and Buzz. You never know when you're going to get a home-cooked meal like this again.
Well, actually, I think it's going to be a lot of fun having different food from all over the country.
Oh, that's true. Now, when Dad and I were traveling, we must have eaten at every fast food chain from Texas to Oregon. It was great. I have lots of fun.
Who's this? Oh, great. You are helping with the silverware.
Daddy? Aye, aye, sir. Hey, you guys, I know I shouldn't tell you this, but I've already decided what I'm going to get you for Christmas.
Okay.
I'm going to take lots of pictures of everybody celebrating at home, especially at Baby Marina, and I'm going to put them in an album, and I'm going to send it to you.
Oh, okay? That's sweet. What a great idea. But you know what, Lucy, by that time, I'm sure Mom and Dad will be on the beaches of Florida just soaking up that sun, huh? Hey, do they have Christmas trees down there? Oh, hey, forget that. You should get one of those fake ones. You know, the ones with all the ornaments and everything else? They look great in the motel rooms.
Come on, Marina, let's see. Yeah, huh? Hey. I guess I'm just a sentimental old fool because it seems like everybody else is taking or leaving in stride.
Oh, Nadine, it's just everybody's trying to make the best of it. That's all. That's all it is.
I hate saying goodbye, and I hate not knowing when I'm going to see my family again.
Well, I think maybe you should go right out there and tell Buzz that you do not want to go.
I can't, Eleni. We have got to go. We have just got to go.
Why? Of course you can. But Nadine, is there something you are not telling me?
Well, it's just that it was Buzz's idea to leave, not mine. And if I don't go with him, he'll go without me because he's done it before. He could do it again. And this time, Eleni, this time I will not be left behind.
Nadine, is that really the reason? Is that really why?
We better get these pies out of the oven before they burn, huh?
Thank you for getting them.
Every year about this time, we tell the story of the first Cooper Thanksgiving to the youngest member of the Cooper family.
What?
That's you. That's a tradition, you know.
Wait a minute, I've never heard of this tradition before.
It's a new tradition, Frank. Did you know that the Coopers came over in the Mayflower? It was in a ship. Your ancestors came over on it. It was like, you know, you could act like a big shot. You were very important. Of course, Grandma, great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandma and Grandpa Cooper were stowaways. But then the people, the regular passengers, weren't so fancy either. I mean, they wore black gabardine, didn't they, and funny hats. They looked so funny, people stoned them in England. We've always, even to this day, had problems with the English. They call these people pilgrims because they wandered around so much. But there they were. They sailed down the chilly coastline of Massachusetts. But it wasn't called Massachusetts then. It was called, what was it? Hookapaka, wicka waka, hookapaka. And they were looking for a place to, you know, a port. And they, Wiley, that was his name, Grandpa Wiley Cooper, found a rock was big enough to put the gangplank on. He called that rock Oldsmobile Rock. And he went on, he went across, and it was windy. And he started a fire in spite of all that. And the Native Americans saw the smoke, and they came down from where they were just to see what was going down. Of course, being natives like they were half naked, which scandalized the pilgrims. That's an odd thing about our species. You know, we're the only species that gets scandalized by naked ones of our own. But of course, Grandpa Wiley, he liked naked people. So he made friends with the Indians, which they were called back then, because the first sailors there mistakenly thought it was Indian. They must have been the Spaldings, those people.
Oh, that's not nice.
So in exchange, they gave him a wild turkey, and he roasted it, and the pilgrims smelled the turkey, and they got less scandalized, and they came out and haggled over the drumsticks. And that is the true story, although you don't find it in books, about how the first Thanksgiving actually went.
Oh, Buzz, I like your story very much. Yeah. But how do you explain that the Coopers were really Couperacuses and they were Greek instead of English?
Well, later on, I'll tell how the Couperacuses founded Athens and started democracy and then went to England and straightened them out. But right now, I'm gonna take care of the ancestor of that first turkey.
Good story. I'm gonna miss you.
Hey. Come with us. Come on. It'll be like old times.
I can't, Dad. I'd love to, but I got burned out on the road, and I just need to stay in one place at one time. Go on. You guys are going to have a great time.
Yeah, sure we are.
So what do you think?
Why, Jenna, you're proposing. I'm deeply touched.
Oh, but that's just it. I would never touch you. Or your money. Well, we would have an agreement. It would be just about the marriage. And we could have a clause in there that it would be null and void the day the baby's born.
No money. Really?
I wouldn't need it, not if my lotion company was taking off.
Would it be ungentlemanly of me if I asked, what's in it for me?
The possibility of getting Tangi. You're wild about her. Now, don't deny it. But you don't want to risk losing the love of your son to get her. So, how do you break them up, but still keep the appearance of being an innocent third party? You marry me!
How does that break them up?
Brilliant. You see, she's got her defenses up around you, all right? So you find someone else. Then Tangi relaxes around you. She feels the heat is off.
In 2 months, you're going to be a free man again. And I am prepared to sacrifice my benevolent reputation and become the hellish wife who used you completely and then tossed you aside. You will be in great need of comfort then.
Jenna, you are the most wonderfully devious woman I have ever known.
I thank you, darling. You'd better give this some serious thought.
As the world turns.
Hi.
Hey.
Oh, thanks, Kitty.
Let me stab you with
this. Hey, Ham. Haven't seen you in a long time. How are you?
I'm doing great. I haven't seen enough of either of you lately. Oh, now, what's happening?
Yeah, well, all that's going to change.
Yeah?
How you doing, Ham?
Well, you know, I'm still trying to find me a good woman that'll have me, but I'm doing all right. Looked like you found one.
Yeah, I sure did.
Dylan.
There's a big guy.
Hey.
Hey, Mindy.
Happy Thanksgiving.
You too.
How you doing?
Nick with you?
Yeah, I'm right here, buddy.
Ham's here, too.
How you doing?
How you doing, big guy? How's my friend doing, huh?
Hey.
Right here.
Hey,
all right, man.
Oh, man, I'm hanging in. How
yeah,
are you?
Well, I thought so. I'm doing okay. You're made out of the same stuff your dad, man. You're real tough, you know? You'd be fine. You
got Dylan, my boy!
Hey! Hey, Granddaddy.
Glad we could all be together today, Dylan.
Hi. Oh, Henry. Boy, everybody's here, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah. I got your cousins here and your brother.
John?
They've all grown about a foot since you were last with them a couple days ago.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You can't grow a foot in 2 days.
Hey.
Can you, Dylan?
No, I don't think so. He's probably just joshing. Hey, just joshing, you got it? Shane here? Shane?
Yeah. You can't see me, kid.
Hey. No,
Shane.
I can't. No, it's all right. I can't see you, but... I figured you'd be here, and little Peter.
Yeah, right here.
And hey, and Bill.
Yeah, I'm here.
Bill, all right. Hey, Bill. Well, anyway, I'm gonna go out on the porch and get some fresh air.
Okay. It's a little nippy out there. You should be all right.
Oh, I like it that way.
Okay. All right. Easy, easy.
You made
stuffing this year.
I did.
Oh no.
Hey. Vanessa, I got your little one here for you.
Funky. Hi, Funky.
Hey, Matt, how you doing?
Good. How's it going?
Oh, do you have a good sleep?
Mindy, my love.
Hi. How are you?
Whoa.
Sweetie, where's Michelle?
She wants
to
spend Thanksgiving with you.
Well, I didn't make anything. Muffin? You know that I always do takeout. Mindy?
Yeah?
I got a present for you.
Oh.
I'll be right back.
Hey, Pete.
Are you done?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, honey, that's terrible. You must be disappointed.
She didn't want to be around all these people feeling sorry for her. Do you know what I think? I think her whole life's been trashed by what her dad did.
No, it hasn't. It just seems like that now.
She's dreading going back to school after Thanksgiving. She knows all the kids will be talking behind her back.
No, they won't. Her real friends won't.
You don't get it, Mom. When a parent does something stupid, the kids get the flack. I know because I went through it with Dad. And he got in trouble. And Michelle's not as strong as me.
Hey, that sounds great. Keep playing.
Where have you been? It took you so long.
I stopped by the jail to see if I could get in to see Uncle Abbott. Visiting hours aren't until later.
Ah.
Hi, you guys.
Hey.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to you, too.
Julie?
You know what? I have to run inside and check on dinner, but you're more than welcome to stay.
Oh, no, thanks. We're meeting my parents.
Oh, all right.
Actually, Dylan, I wanted to stop by and ask if you'd heard from David.
Yeah, he's fine. He's, good. He called me yesterday.
Good, good. After reading that article in the journal, I got really worried about him. The article said that the police were looking for David after he helped his friend Gabriella escape. You wouldn't happen to know anything about that, would you?
No, he'll probably explain it to you when he gets here.
Mm. Well, Dylan, I tell you what, why don't you tell David from me that if he needs any help straightening out things with the police, that I'll make myself available to him, all right? Anytime.
Sure, Sid, that's great. I don't think he's done anything wrong, though.
Well, listen, if you talk to him again, please tell him to call me. I really want to talk to him.
Sure, no problem.
All right.
See, I was hoping that he would be here for dinner, you know, take the heat off of me.
Oh, don't worry. My mother will surely talk of nothing else but David and how he's the black sheep of the family again. Sure was nice when she declared a truth. Dylan, you take care of yourself,
all right? You too. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thanks.
And you too.
Let's not avoid the inevitable.
Come on.
Mind if I join you, my boy?
And Daddy. What's happening?
Well, son, I've been over a few rough spots myself, so I'll try not to say anything dumb.
But whatever, Dylan, don't you stop believing that you've got a future. You do, you know. And whether you want it or not, that's a life there to be lived. And all you got to do is decide what you're going to make of it now that you've been dealt a new hand.
Yeah, well, things are coming along little by little, you know. A lot of people got it worse than I do, though.
Pretending a problem doesn't exist ain't the same as dealing with it. And don't you ever lie to yourself about that. When you face your worst fears, and when you get to know what they are, then you come to know that you can beat them, no matter what they are. You remember that.
You know, everybody's around here trying to cheer me up, and all it does is depress me. Thank you for the straight talk.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Oh, my boy.
This is WSPR-TV, and you're about to hear a replay of Dr. Ed Bauer's news conference, when the so-called hit-and-run doc actually implored the hit-and-run driver who seriously...
Enough.
I am in the business of reporting the news, Holly.
Listen, I take offense too, Dad. I mean, I am close with Ed.
It's no use appealing to your father's conscience on this matter. When it comes to Ed, he doesn't have any.
At the risk of repeating myself, I'm a news person, as are you, and this is news.
This is tabloid trash,
darling. You know, speaking of the Journal account, I think it has helped get rid of insomnia across the greater Springfield area.
Thank you.
At least the Journal's not going to be sued for libel.
Okay. Is that a veiled threat? I ask you.
Time out.
Yes, dear.
Darling, sweetheart, you know that family thing you're always talking about? This is it. Mm-hmm. Here we are.
Okay, and a very litigious one, it would seem. I won't say another word about St. Ed.
Roger, please.
Don't. Look, if you had to put up with this holier-than-thou attitude for as many years as I...
Well, he is holier-than-thou.
Okay, look, I am not unsympathetic to the feelings of his family, his friends, his attorney, his ex-wife, even.
Look... Is this all about my being upset over Alex? We're even now. So if you mention Ed's name one more time, I'm going to leave. Oh!
I'll get it.
Tansy.
Hi.
Tansy. Come on in.
Wait, am I late?
No,
you're right on time. Let me take this coat, please.
Oh, okay. Here, Blake.
Oh, thank you.
They were anxious for more company.
Good to
see you guys.
It's really good to see you, and I'm just so looking forward to spending another Thanksgiving with you, Tangie.
Well, I am too.
Well, I guess it probably is time to start lifting little lids and pots and things.
Yes, be my guest. Go on. Go on, do it. And could you check the gravy for me, Mom?
Yes.
Thanks.
Okay. Excuse me. I need an aspirin.
Oh, I'm sorry, but you know, my husband and my father in the same room is like murder, but I don't know what to do because I love both of them. I'm so glad you're here. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine. It was just a mistake not to tell Alan Michael that my mystery friend was his father.
You told him? What happened?
Well, Alan and I told him together, which was a mistake because I should have told him on my own. Inadvertently, Alan really made it sound a lot worse than it was.
Oh, inadvertent, my left foot. I've warned you about Alan Spaulding. There is nothing that man does that is inadvertent. I mean, every step, every word he utters is so carefully calculated to achieve his ends.
All right. Tenzi. Ah,
yes.
Why don't you sit right here?
All right.
Ready to
Thank
go,
you.
Holly? Okay. You'd be so kind right here.
Lovely.
And Roger,
Thank
you can sit right here.
Uh-huh. Okay, where are you sitting, Ross?
At the head of the table, of course.
I can't sit.
You know, never in all my life have I heard of a guest refusing to sit where the host wants them to sit.
You are forgetting about this.
Roger, please. Don't wave the thing around, please, all right? Don't wave it.
Don't worry, I have no intention of being yet another prominent citizen to become a crime statistic.
Roger.
Sorry. But I do need room to carve. Look at this, you know?
Honey, just...
All right, never mind, Holly. It's not worth fighting about besides he's armed. Go ahead. You want to sit on the table? Sit on the table.
No. And I'm not going to usurp your place, but I do need a little room just to carve the turkey, which I presume is going to be over here. All right.
Right.
And then I will be docile. Docile papa.
Honey.
Well, I forgot to put the... take off the foil tent to let it brown, so it came out, blonde.
Ah.
I'm sorry.
Not to me, no. And I call
excuse me. I'm sorry. Josh, I'm just wondering, are you guys still considering accepting our offer to help Louis Orla out with a loan?
It was a very generous offer, and we are taking it under consideration, and we should have an answer for you in the next couple of days.
No business today. None.
Can I help, or am I listening to you?
Ashley! No, I'm okay right now. Maybe in 2 minutes, help us step out. Because I need the basket for the biscuit.
Vanessa, can I talk to you in private for a minute?
Sure.
You know, don't you? You know that Nick is trying to bankrupt the family in order to put pressure on you.
Well, I had suspicions.
I did, but I don't have any facts, so I haven't made a judgment.
It's true.
Nick had the bank move on Louis Oil.
You want proof?
I have proof right here. It's an agreement with the bank signed by Nick.
Be around for a long time.
Beautiful.
There we go.
There you are.
Good job.
All right.
Do you need help in there?
I'm short. Oh, come in.
Oh, you know, everybody's really starving. I think the gentleman wouldn't mind a blonde.
Look, everybody just stop badgering me, okay? Because you're gonna get a brown turkey if it kills me.
Welcome to Thanksgiving Hell.
Oh, my God, don't.
Have a seat.
Hi, Carol. Hey, happy Thanksgiving. Hey, hello. Hello, Carol.
All right. This looks great.
I was going to say grace, but, I got to get something off my chest, and it's about dreams, I think. Nadine and I are going to be making a pilgrimage of our own, and all my life I've dreamed about precious objects, you know, silver, crystals, houses on hills. Cars. But right now, this moment, I am thunderstruck that everything I need is here. This table, these faces, this celebration. Wherever we go, however far away, each of you will be in our hearts every moment. I mean that. Lord. Lord. Lord, Lord, thank you for the blessings you've bestowed on all of us, and speaking for Buzz, I know that all I need is right here in this diner.
Somebody did this word to him fairly well.
Well, money
time for her to take her nap.
Time already.
Yeah. Oh, hi, Daddy. Okay, bye, Carol. Good night.
Good night. Good night. Pleasant night. Dreams.
This portion of Guiding Light has been presented by Smooth Texture Metamucil, the natural choice for regularity.